Do you know what to do if you get lost in the woods? If not, the results could be deadly. Case in point, in 2013, Geraldine Largue, known as Inchworm on trail, began her hike of the Appalachian Trail starting in Harpers Ferry, West Virginia. She hiked over 1,000 miles up into the wilderness of Maine, and the majority of that hike was done with a friend of hers. And in addition to doing it with this friend, her husband was also driving up along the AT, supporting her along her way. The friend, unfortunately, had to get off the trail for a family emergency, and so Inchworm continued on the trail by herself with the support of her husband. But of course, she couldn't see her husband every day because there just aren't, you know, that's not realistic with the road system along the trail. The friend said that Inchworm was slow, hence her name, and she was prone to going the wrong direction, and she would get sort of combative if she made a mistake. Her husband said that she may have been in over her head. Apparently, in addition to not having the best sense of direction, Inchworm also was on some anti-anxiety medication, and when she didn't have her medication, she was prone to panic attacks. Anyway, she stepped off the trail up in Maine in a really dense part of the wilderness with a lot of trees, and she stepped off to use the restroom, and she lost her sense of where the trail was, and she ended up lost. She ended up trying to send some texts to her husband to say, "Hey, I stepped off the trail. I'm lost. I'm not sure which direction the trail is. I can't get back to it. Can you contact police or can you contact whoever to get me some help and to tell me what to do?" Unfortunately, she did not have cell phone reception, and apparently she even tried to climb up a hill or a mountain to try to get cell phone reception, but to no avail, so her text messages never went through. And just to note that I have Verizon cell service, and I had pretty good service throughout the AT, especially when I was on the tops of mountains, but my worst cell phone reception was probably in Maine. I noticed I would go the longest, like I would have the longest stretches without cell phone reception when I was in the state of Maine. And definitely Maine and I'd say New Hampshire are probably the wildest parts of the trail where you actually feel the most like you are out there in the wilderness. She ended up setting up camp in a pretty dense part of the forest. And even though there were search parties out looking for her, including helicopters and people on foot, she never made it back out of the woods. Her body was found about 2 years later. She died of exposure and starvation in her tent. It's a really sad story, and you know, I think that those of us who spend a lot of time in the woods have definitely at some point or another had a thought like, "Oh, do I know where I'm going? Do I know how to get back to the trail?" But I think that she was not well prepared. She didn't know what she was supposed to do when lost in the wilderness, and she made some missteps, and unfortunately it led to her death. So super sad, super tragic, but I wanted to use this opportunity of telling this story as kind of a teaching moment and to talk about some of the things that you are supposed to do if you do get lost in the woods to better your chances of survival. So I'm going to give you some tips from the Forest Service on how you're supposed to act and what you're supposed to do if you do find yourself lost in the wilderness. But before that, I just want to mention that a lot of times in Colorado where I live, we don't have cell phone reception out in the wilderness. Like, you know, you'll go the whole day or the whole backpacking trip and not have any cell phone service. It's very common. A lot of times when I'm driving, I don't have cell phone service. So something that I have done to make myself feel a little more comfortable out in the wilderness, especially because I do a lot of hiking alone, is I've gotten myself a GPS device, and I would recommend that for anyone spending a lot of time in the wilderness. It's given me so much peace of mind. There are a lot of different brands, but I got the Garmin InReach Mini. It was pretty pricey. It was about $350. And I also have to pay a monthly subscription, which I have the lowest one, which I believe is about $12 a month. But it's so worth it when I think about what could happen if I actually got lost in the woods, because this device connects to an app on my phone that will show me a map of the wilderness area that I'm in and exactly where in the wilderness area that I am. So if I'm off the trail, I can watch it and use it to lead myself back to the trail. In addition, I can use it to send text messages. And I can also use it to contact emergency services / search and rescue. So there's an SOS button on the side of the device. And if I ever found myself in a bind, I could push that button to get in touch with search and rescue. So, you know, of course, when you're out in the wilderness, it can take some time for search and rescue to get to you. Sometimes if you are trying to get in touch with them at night, like, you're not going to really be able to until morning. So there are some caveats. It's not a magic, you know, fix all if you find yourself in a bind, but at least it's a landline to people that can help you, as opposed to just being lost or having an emergency or something like that and not having cell phone service and not being able to get in touch with anyone. So there are lots of brands. Spot is another popular brand. I really like my Garmin, but if you're spending a lot of time in the wilderness, I would definitely recommend spending the money to get one, and I'll definitely be using this on my future through hikes. And by the way, Inchworm was found dead less than a mile from the AT. Apparently she wasn't found both because she had set up in a really dense area under some trees, so she couldn't be seen by helicopters or anything like that. And also she had set up in a part of land that was owned by the military, and so the search parties weren't actually allowed on the military land to actually go search for her. So it was just really unfortunate that that's where she ended up. Really sad, but again, she was less than a mile from the trail, so I feel like if she had a GPS device, she could have easily gotten herself back to the trail. Okay, so here are the tips from the Forest Service. First and foremost, make sure when you're going out on a hike, you have the 10 essentials. There's no way I'm going to be able to name these all off the top of my head, so I'm going to drop a link to the 10 essentials below. But basically, this includes, you know, extra layers, some sort of shelter, extra water, extra food, a map, a compass, something to start a fire, a flashlight, etc. And they recommend that you always have a paper map and a compass, because obviously your cell phone could fail, your GPS device may not be able to get signal, that sort of thing. But when you can use a GPS device, I do find it to be a lot easier than using a map and a compass, because again, it will show you exactly where you are in the wilderness area, so there's no guesswork like if you're using a map. And then at least with my Garmin InReach Mini, it shows me on a little dot in the map, and then as I move, the dot will move. I mean, I'm not saying don't use a map and compass. Absolutely, that is a safety item that you should have and you should know how to use it. I just find the GPS device, I like how interactive it is and how it moves along with me. Okay, and the Forest Service says that your most important tool if you are lost in the woods is a good, positive attitude. Whatever you do, do not panic, because panic is gonna mess you up. It's gonna mess things up for you. You're gonna make poor, rash decisions. So what you wanna do is stay calm, stay logical, stay in the moment where you are, and do not panic. Do not race to conclusions. Stay calm. Then you want to look around you, think about where is it that I came from, and what landmarks do I recognize? Don't take a step until you have a plan in place and know where you are going to go from there and why. Get out your map and compass or GPS device and go the direction based on logic. Okay, so like if you were going on the trail north and you have gone east off of the trail, obviously to get back on the trail, you want to go west. If you are on the trail, do not leave the trail. And then as a last resort, if you really can't figure out where you should be going based on the direction, based on landmarks, based on where you think you came from, then follow a stream or a drainage downstream, because often this will lead to either a trail or a road. But that should be your last resort, because obviously if you're going off the trail, then it could end up being dangerous. There could be obstacles. You could end up farther in the wilderness. So this is your last resort. Make sure you're coming up with a plan though, and not just wandering aimlessly. And then obviously if you find yourself hurt or exhausted or a night is falling, then you wanna come up with a place to stay for the night where you can feel safe and protected and not just be wandering around in the dark. If you do keep moving, be smart about it. Make sure that you stop and rest when you're tired. Make sure you're drinking enough water, eating enough food. You are fixing small problems as they arise so they don't turn into big problems. If you're hiking in the heat of the summer, don't hike during the hottest part of the day, and make sure that you do have a plan in place. And according to the National Forest Foundation, if you do decide to stay in place due to an injury or exhaustion or something like that, make sure you are in a clear spot so that rescuers can potentially see you from above or see you in the clear. So this is obviously a mistake that Inchworm made. She made her camp in a really, in an area with a lot of trees overhead, so she wasn't able to be seen. So make sure you are out in the clear if you are staying put, and make a smoke signal if you have the capability to do that. Apparently a signal fire is the quickest way to gain attention, so that is your best bet. They also emphasize that keeping a clear head and not panicking is your best chance for survival. And by the way, I always bring an external battery in addition to my cell phone and GPS device, because obviously your cell phone can die, your GPS device can die, and this gives you a little extra protection in that you can charge your devices while you're in the wilderness. And I always make sure to charge all my devices before I go out. This is an Anker brand. I actually have a much bigger one of these as well, but they're, you know, like anything, there are a bunch of different brands. I would just say Anker is the most popular. And if you're interested, I will drop a link to one of these chargers below, in addition to the GPS device. Thanks for listening, you guys. Be safe out there. I hope this video has given you a little bit of good information on what you should do if you find yourself lost in the wilderness. And yeah, be safe. Have fun, of course, while out hiking. Don't forget to like this video if you got some value out of it. Subscribe to my channel for more hiking, backpacking, Appalachian Trail, and Colorado content. And check me out over on Instagram at Audie Payne. Thanks so much for being here, and I'll talk to all you guys later. See ya.